Dear aspirants, today we are going to discuss about the TAT test of the psychological test. It is thematic appreciation test. You have to appreciate the picture and then you write down a story. But there are laid down norms for that, that you can see that picture for 30 seconds and then write a story in within 4 minutes. And in the same manner, continuously you have to write 12 such stories. 30 seconds picture, 4 minute story, 30 second picture, 4 minutes for the story. It is quite a tedious process, let me tell you. If you write 2 long stories, I am very sure that by the time you will be writing your 9th or 10th story, you will not be knowing what your hand is writing. So, and getting a correct thought process while running with such a speed is very difficult if you write long stories. If you write very short stories, again, then you are not able to express your ideas in a correct and appropriate manner. So, you have to take a why media. What can you write within 4 minutes? Keep 15 second question with you. Whatever story you want to write, within 3.5, approximately around 3.5 minutes, you should be able to complete it, and you should be waiting for the next story on the screen, next picture on the screen. Then your thought process will work out. Otherwise, you will keep struggling. One more thing I want to tell you. Lot of cadets, they keep asking me, sir, we first create problem, then we have to make him successful. No, creating problem and solving has got various angles to it. I will give you an example. In a class, there is one student who with lot of struggle gets passing marks. There is another student who is somewhere around 90, and by getting around 90-95%, he wants to be the topper of the class. Don't you think both of them have got a problem? The student who is getting 90%, he has got a problem. He wants to top the class by getting 95% marks approximately. And the student who is hardly getting 40, and then he starts expecting that he will get 95% marks, he has also got a problem. But you see, which problem has got a negative aspect and a logical aspect? A person for last 10 years, he has been getting 40%, hardly 40% passing marks. And then one fine morning, he starts burning midnight oil, and then he scores 95% and he becomes the topper of the class. I don't think it stands to logic. Possibility can never be ruled out, but you will agree with me, for such student, problem existed, but then aspiring to be the class topper becomes a difficult situation. But a student who has got a problem, he is getting 90%, but he wants to score 95% and want to top the class. I think this is a better situation. He has also got a problem. He wants to solve it, and he lands up solving it. You can't make him total hardly passing marks, hardly any good academic background, then sir, one fine morning you make him the topper, and then you take him to the topper of IAS also. No, the creating problem is a different concept. You have to visualize things in a correct order, logical manner. Everybody writes a poor farmer. How a farmer, every farmer can be poor? No, I don't agree this. India is a land of agriculture, they are very prosperous farmers also. And they have got good production, good yield. And if somebody wants to improve it, then he can also employ the various modern techniques, hybrid seeds, fertilizers, pesticides, insecticides, what all is required. The higher production can be taken to the highest level, but not from the lowest level to the highest level. That's what I mean to say. Lot of cadets discuss this thing with me. Another thing, cadets tend to write things which they have never done, they have never experienced. Somebody wants to write about war, somebody writes about the army life, somebody wants to write about NCC life. When you don't know a particular thing, let me assure you, you will end up writing an incorrect thing and which will go against you. Surely it will go against you. If you have not participated in a blood donation camp during your school time, your college time, and even after that, and before that, do you think you can write a story on blood donation camp correctly? Certainly your sequence of action will not be correct. My sincere advice to those people who are not participating in such kind of events, whether it is a cricket match or football match, you may, if you are not in a playing team, then you might as well be in the administrative team. You will know how to organize a cricket match or a cricket tournament for that matter, or a hockey tournament for that matter. If you have not participated in dramatics or any extracurricular activity, whatever story you may be write, your step can never be correct, because neither you have watched it nor you have done it. So don't try stunts while writing stories. These are my sincere advice. And how come you see everything negative? No. When you see a lady sleeping on bed, people say she is bedridden. How it can be possible? You make him sick, make her sick. No, that's not possible. You have to look from positive angle. If somebody, some lady or gents is sleeping on bed, he may be resting. He must have done hard work for the throughout the day or night. Now he is relaxing after achieving his aim. But you make him bedridden, then somebody is looking after, somebody is getting medicine for him. No, that is not life. Have a positive view. And my sincere advice, very, very sincere advice to those people who try to bunk the events during class, college or university or in the local social life, my sincere advice, participate. Participate to the extent whatever is possible for you. If there is a blood donation camp, why not to go there? If there is a celebration event, you should go. If you are getting a chance to participate or to be a cadet in NCC, attend it. You will gain a lot of experience. You attend a camp every year. Attending camp is a totally different experience. That is a lifetime experience. NCC or NSS, all such activities build you, get you into a team spirit. Alone, you cannot work in these organizations. In NCC, you attend the camps at national level. Even bright cadets, they get a chance to attend the Republic Day Parade. They attend Prime Minister's Rally. They get a chance to visit so many VIPs during that RD Parade time. A very selected cadets, they go for Youth Exchange Program also. So, there are opportunities. When you attend these events, you will gain experience. And whatever you will write in a flow will only be correct and only correct, because you have gone through that process. Half of the people are not able to write correct stories because they write total fiction. You have not, that's why attending extracurricular activities is very important. Participation in games and sports is very important. Holding appointments like class prefect or a house prefect or a sports captain, they have got extra responsibilities. They will be facing the same exam which you will be facing, but they are holding extra responsibilities. It means they are devoting their time to an event, to their responsibilities. They learn in that. You keep skipping the events, then that time you feel very smart. His sir has told me or my madam has told me to do this. I have told her I have got a stomachache or I am not feeling well. I can't come. But these bunking habits, these escapism will lead you to not on a right footing, I can say. That is incorrect footing. You may feel you are very smart that time, but in a long run you are getting harmed. These stories are nothing. It is very simple. What is stories? What is this word test, situation reaction? You see a thing, express the correct reaction. It will be correct. But when you don't participate, you don't learn, how it can be possible? Only going through books and getting high score is not the solution. You need an overall personality development. You participate in an event, it becomes a lifetime event. You will never forget it, I can assure you. But if you maro bunk, in your complete life, you can never learn it. You attend an NCC camp, lifetime experience. You attend a blood donation camp, lifetime experiment. You assist your teachers during your annual day functions. It's a lifetime experience. Come what may, you may become an old man of 80 or 100 years, you will never forget these experiences. And whatever you describe, that has to be correct. And that is TAT. That's why people who participate in activities, who enjoy taking extra responsibilities, they write well, their appreciation is correct. So, think logical, don't think of big problems and then solving it. Every day we go through a lot of events in life. Take things in a correct perspective, you will be successful. TAT, thematic appreciation test, writing story, will become so easy. It is nothing but plan it. Don't write very long, don't write very short. Use appropriate words. I will tell you, like, when you say ki I have gone to a particular place, don't know whether you have gone, you are serious or not serious, whether you have noted down the facts and figure, how much you have concentrated, not clear. But when you say I have visited that place, that is very forceful. That says you have gone very deliberately, you have noted down facts and figure, and you know things in detail. Your words, what you write, matters. Use correct words, use selective words, they carry weight. If you write casual words, that depicts, that clearly shows your casual attitude. If your words are casual, you are also casual. You can't hide things. These are some of the tips which I could have discussed. Thank you. If you found my guidance useful, then go to my page on Instagram and Quora and practice some more. Go to link in description, practice more. I want to see you all as future defense officers.